What are some of the little details that are really similar to real-life NASCAR racing in the film?
I was so amazed with not just the cars and the things, but the background stuff, the things on the dirt track at Thomasville Speedway when they're doing the practicing, the way that clay looks and cracks and the landscape behind it, that's exactly the way those old racetracks look. And the way the red clay in North Carolina cracks like that is really, really amazing how they got it to be so exact.
How do you get that so exact?
A lot of research. We have an amazing team at Pixar, obviously, and an amazing eye for detail. And when we do our research trips, when we come to places like North Carolina, you realize the sky is different, the clouds are different, the dirt, everything is different when you travel, and the U.S. is a big country. And so we really pay attention to those things. And it's not just photo research, it's really going and touching that ground and feeling it and doing that. That's the only way you can really get that stuff right.
Oh, there's so many.
We try to do everything we could. And anytime a decision has to be made, you know, we have to create everything from scratch. So we might as well create it factual, you know? There's a moment where cars are on a treadmill and they're exercising and their engine sound is coming up. And there's little graphics on their little screens that show their speed and their RPMs. And we made sure we matched where would those RPMs actually be on a car like them in real life to make sure it's in line with their speeds.
Even our Skywalker sound people went down to Jay Leno's garage because he had a Nash, and so the sound of the car starting and the exhaust sounded like the Nash in Louis Smith's car.
Yeah, all the cars, yeah. As much as possible, every one of the historic cars are recorded the actual real car so that their engine would be as accurate as possible.
The way the cars were, but the way the trucks were, the way the stadiums were, the racing stadium that they raced in that looked like Bristol, Tennessee and Daytona and Charlotte all rolled into one. The interaction between the drivers, and in this case, the interaction between the cars, between Lightning McQueen and Cal Weathers and everybody that came along. And the respect for the history, but I think just the interaction was the detail that got me the most. I thought, oh my God, I'm standing here talking to a bunch of other drivers. That's just cars talking to cars, but it was really cool.
And did you notice the same relationships you have with those people in real life? The cars had them as well.
Yes.
And that was the cool part, because it was like, if I'm mad at you and you're mad at me in real life, if we were cars, we'd be mad at each other too. So it was, that part really was. And to watch that develop, to go back in time and watch the history of it with Mr. The King, who is my father in real life, to watch him and then to watch Lightning McQueen and to come on to where we're at. It was pretty cool.
So I'm here with Daniel Suarez, who is not only a NASCAR champion, but also the voice of Daniel Suarez in Cars 3. I would love to know what it's like to see yourself as an animated car on the big screen.
Something very good, you know, to have the opportunity to race cars for a living every weekend, and as well, obviously, to have my debut, you know, in the big screen with Pixar, with the Cars 3 movie, something fabulous. You know, I grew up as a kid watching all these movies.
How does racing in an animated movie compare to racing in real life?
Well, it is different. It is different for sure, but you know, just racing in. Racing in real life, it just takes a lot of work. It's a team sport for sure. I have a lot of people working with me to try to make my race car just a little bit faster and a little bit faster. Engineers, speed crew that change tires and fuel in 10 seconds, just like Louis does in the movie. So it's very cool to see all these interactions in the movie and to see the real life, how it works.
So it's actually a bit more realistic than you'd think.
I think it is. And actually, if you think about it, my character is one of the new upcoming drivers in the movie. And in the real life, I'm actually in exactly the same point. I won the championship last year in the middle division of NASCAR and NASCAR Xfinity Series, and now we're in the Cup Series. So I feel like we're in exactly the same spot.